Hi, I'm Dr. Zimmerman. In this video, we're going to walk through one example of computing a confidence interval for a population proportion. I collected data from a random sample of 30 Stat 200 students. Each student was asked whether or not they're currently living in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. Of the 30 students who were sampled, 15 said yes, that they were currently living in Pennsylvania. We're going to use this information to construct a 95% confidence interval for the proportion of the population of Stat 200 students who are currently living in Pennsylvania. First, we need to check assumptions. Recall, in order to use the normal approximation method, both n times p and n times 1 minus p must be at least 10. In this case, n times p, which is actually the number of successes, or in this case, the number of students who said yes, they were living in Pennsylvania, equals 15. And n times 1 minus p is the number of failures, or the number of students who said no, they're not currently living in Pennsylvania. In this case, 30 minus 15, which is also 15. We have at least 10 successes and at least 10 failures, so we can use the normal approximation method to construct the 95% confidence interval with these data. The formula for constructing a confidence interval for a population proportion is p hat, so the sample proportion, plus or minus the z multiplier times the standard error, which is equal to the square root of p hat times 1 minus p hat divided by n. So we can start by computing the sample proportion. 15 out of 30 students said yes, they're currently living in Pennsylvania. So my sample proportion is 0.5. Can now plug this into the formula. So p hat is 0.5 plus or minus the z multiplier. You can get this from the z table or using software such as Minitab Express. The z multiplier is the z score that separates the middle 95% of the z distribution from the outer 5%. So the outer 5% is split between two tails. So there's 2.5% at the top and 2.5% at the bottom. This is one of the most common confidence levels, so I can tell you that the z score that separates the middle 95% from the outer 5% is plus and minus 1.960. So our z multiplier is 1.960. Now we can compute the standard error as 0.5 times 1 minus 0.5 divided by the sample size, which was 30. And we can compute the standard error now. So 0.5 times 1 minus 0.5 is 0.25 divided by 30. Take the square root of that will give you a standard error of 0.091. We multiply that value by 1.960. We get 0.179. So our lower bound is 0.5 minus 0.179, which gives us 0.321. And our upper bound is going to be 0.5 plus 0.179, which will give us 0.679. This is our 95% confidence interval. So to interpret this, I would say that I am 95% confident that in the population of all Stat 200 students, between 32.1% and 67.9% are currently living in Pennsylvania.